Well, welcome everybody. Today's day 233. Make it Songbringer. You can't even see the game with all my stuff on my desktop. But yeah, it's been a whirlwind of marketing this last week. I'm very excited to have the alpha version's gameplay trailer finished online, and now I'm just promoting it. So today's gonna be a marketing day. I'm going to start touching up the Twitch page, posting to Facebook, things like that. I'm just going to share the marketing of the game because this is something that's really important to do as an indie, you know, game developer. Share your stuff daily and it'll grow. So what's first? I got this rad GIF. Amongst many other gifts. Oh, here it is. This is just like a mayhem gif. I think I'm gonna post it with double the size on TigSource. Maybe Facebook as well. Alright, so let's get this thing at 200%. This makes it look good. You know, being bigger, but it also makes the gifts bigger. Alright, so we got Lossy 9. Let's put that down to 6. All right, it's a pretty big GIF, but it's okay for Giphy. All right, so let's post this thing on Giphy. Tags, gaming, Alex Pita. What's up, my friend? Ciao, bello. What's up, JFK? Yo, man. How you guys doing today? Jonah19. What's up, y'all? Just doing some marketing here. Super stoked about the alpha gameplay trailer. You guys have probably already seen it. But if you haven't seen it, here's the new alpha trailer. So, it's been a busy week. It's been pretty much marketing all week this week. Nice, right on. I can't wait to be doing that myself. I gotta relax today. We were at a party yesterday. That's why I wasn't streaming yesterday. So I was at this party and I stayed up until sunrise. So I'm pretty tired today. All right, we got the GIF. It's posted on Facebook. Finishing your CV? CV. What's that stand for? Oh, it doesn't look like this worked yet. I've seen that happen before where I sent out a picture and it didn't work. Oh, your curriculum. Right on. Awesome. Just finishing? Or are you working on finishing? Cool. What's your, do you have like a paper you do at the end? What do you call those again? Thesis? If so, what's your thesis about? All right, let's post a TIG source. So I really gotta, this is what I'm, what's next on my list is like going through and updating all these old GIFs. I gotta update all these. This is old news, such old GIFs. So got so much better art now. So, but anyways, I'm gonna post on the end of this thread. What's up, Egloff? MusicR1? Yo, you guys, welcome. Welcome. All right, let's post this GIF here. Oh, it's a resume? Sorry, I'm kind of brain dead today. All night partying last night. Curriculum vitae? Oh. Oh. Oh, yeah? Oh, really? What field did you start in? Good, man. Going so good. So for anybody just joining the stream, I'm working on marketing today. I've been saying, you know, I'm going to share this more often, these little marketing bits of marketing stuff, because I know it's really valuable for you, some of you guys to watch this, you know, like this is a really right up your alley. These are things you need to see. So, I mean, this is simple stuff. Marketing is pretty easy. It's really just all about graphics and writing good stuff about your game and putting it out there and sharing it and stuff. Deep Thoughts by Nathaniel Weiss. So yeah, I'm gonna post this crazy GIF here. Nice, yeah. I'm glad you like that. I put that in at the very end. Like, you know, it'd be really funny if they talked right here about this. And I actually added a cool system to the game for that where it can detect if you're bored. So, or if the player's bored. Why is this going crazy? Applied informatics. Oh, okay. What's up, Gab Monkey? Yeah, so here's that new system. Where is that? Oh, Alpha 1. So yeah, the key for the story is bored. So it's got a new system right there where it can detect if the player's bored. So that's pretty cool. That's how I did that little scene for the end of this video. All right, cool. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much, you guys. Azaris, what's up? Welcome to the stream. Yeah, so anybody watching on YouTube or whatever, just joining the stream, This game just got its alpha version released, so there's an alpha gameplay trailer up. I'm gonna post the link again if anybody hasn't seen it. Love for you to take a look and tell me what you think, or yeah, so I want to post the link. Let's do the other link. Let's do this, the short link, the shorty. Shorty link, where are you? Just go to this alpha gameplay trailer. Yeah. Akuma, dude, that is a golden idea right there. Golden, man. I'm telling you, you got some good thoughts. Right, so I'm posting to the TIGSource forum, or the TIGSource devlog for this game, with the new game play trailer and this GIF. And I think I'm gonna link the GIF to the trailer. So yeah, if anybody's following along to my previous videos and stuff, this week, this whole week has been just marketing. I've finished the alpha version, well, as best as I could. There's still 100 bugs left or something crazy, but I, this is the best I can do with it for now. So I put it out, and then I finally got the video done. And so now I'm still marketing. So it'll probably be another day or two of updating everything. I want to, freshen up this TIGSource page. I want to freshen up the actual songbringer.com, the Twitch channel. Everything has new graphics and stuff to use. So yeah, totally. Yeah, dude. That's what I'm saying, man. Golden idea. Oh, okay. So you played on permadeath, and save and exit is really easy to abuse. Oh, no, that's a good idea. Maybe save on exit. Doesn't work if there's enemies on the screen. Good call. Yeah, so thank you guys so much for all your incredible feedback. I mean, I've gotten so many emails from just like tons of stuff to fix in the game, like a lot of bugs you guys found. So thank you, because every one of those is going to be a, a good fix for the beta version. So the beta version will probably be like December or January. And hopefully by then there'll be all 9 bosses and stuff. In fact, this scene right here, where there's just a ton of mayhem going on with all these black orb enemies. This mayhem is really fun. It's so fun to play this. So I think this might be one of the bosses, or a mini boss or something like this, is where you just fight 99 of these black guys. And then there's like 99 of the burrowing guys in another room, and 99 of, 99 anything is kind of fun to play. It's just these hordes of enemies. It's just rad. Yeah. I think they would. They would respawn. Yeah. They would definitely respawn, and you would have to start from the beginning. So if you, I guess what's, yeah. Right now, if you play the game in permadeath and then you get stuck or whatever, you're gonna have to go backwards in the actual game though. So if whenever you save and exit, you have to go back to the beginning of the level or the beginning of the game. So there's that. You have to backtrack if you do exit. So that is kind of one negative deterrent to just saving and exiting from the game in permadeath mode too much. Yeah, oh yeah. What's up, Turdicus Bergigus? Yo, man. Oh, Solar Flare, thank you, man. Cool. I will definitely do that. And in fact, for the next 3 months or so, that's going to be one of my focuses is working on the Steam page. I really want to make that way more lively. There's so much art I can share on there. Like there's a whole art section on the Steam discussions. I really want to spiffy up the page on Steam and everything. I think the Steam page is going to be my focus social network for the next 3 months. If I do a good job of marketing that will be really, really good for the game's release and all that. So I think that's a good area to focus on. I mean, it's already got a good website. I've already got a decent Facebook page started, a YouTube, everything. All the social networks are looking good, but Steam, I really haven't done anything to make this Steam page look that great. I posted some new graphics. I got this new gameplay trailer up, but I really need to get into this whole description, post an announcement about the alpha version and all that. Nice, man. Yeah, thank you. Thank you. I might even get on there right now. Let me finish posting this reply here. I think this looks good. So now it's got a link to the video. Or it should. Yeah. YouTube. Cool. Yeah, let's post that. Okay. All right. Cool. I'll save for later then. Nice. Yeah, I really appreciate you guys sharing your thoughts on the game. And because really, some of the best ideas for the game have come from the live stream or just anyone that's interacting with the game on whatever social network. But, especially here on Twitch, I'd say, because we get to interact together right in the moment, So that's, I'm really, really grateful for that. So thank you guys. Thank you, everyone, sharing your feedback, your ideas, suggestions. Bugs you found, What up, Marza? Ha! Ciao, bello! So I'm gonna go ahead and post and screenshot Saturday too. I always like to go through and on screenshot Saturday and look at the other games on here that have been posted this week. Because sometimes I'll find one and I'm like, oh wow, that game looks rad. I mean, all these pretty much look rad today, but I'm really looking for ones where I really, really. Oh, look at that, dude. That looks so much like Metroid Helmet. It's kind of a cool game. The record is 14. 14. The whole thing was lit up. BC Warriors 14. Look at this. Oh, the whole thing. Well, I guess there's Arcor in here twice. We started doing twice, so, But this is a pretty good screenshot, right? Marza, huh? Huh? Mighty Ness, what's up, man? Overcaster? When does your check come in the mail? This is pretty, look at this. This is epic right here. Epic. If you're not in there, it's not valid. Can you make the Twitch window bigger? Oh, dude, you can make it bigger. Oh, see, now we got more room. Okay, now we're ready to have like a real run of 17 or so. When that moment comes and Mars is here, this will be the ultimate. I'm not, I think it might be unshatterable like it is the ultimate. The ultimate ultimateness. Terrarium land. Oh, look at this jetpacky game. Oh, Plasmoid. Cool. Yeah, dude, some of the best games coming out are all here on TIG Source. So if you're making a game, make sure and start a TIG Source thread on the devlog. Don't go on the main page. Check out TIG Source before you just post. I filled up my window. Dude, my window is full already. Look at this. Full. No, but yeah, next goal for BC Warriors, fill it with BC Warriors. We're going to have 17 or 18 or 19 in here. Might as well get started right now. Oh, yeah. Yeah, anybody watching the stream, you know what to do. It's just natural. Just let it flow. That's what I'm talking about. We're about halfway there. Come on, you know you want to. Nice. We're over halfway. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Wait, I can't even count today. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That's pretty good. 10 already. That is a decent run. Oh, RPG Dev, thank you. Making it 11. Oh, 12. Do 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 do. No one else? Oh, Akuma, thank you, thank you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. That is a genuine run of 14 right there. This is a world record tie. Taking a screenshot. Come on, we only got like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more to go. We have the whole window. Entire window. That's the most I could possibly get in a single screenshot on this computer. Yeah, thank you, Akros. Cool, yeah, let's post here in screenshots Saturday. So anyway, it's just joined the stream. I'm doing marketing today. I just released the alpha version of Songbringer. Lots of people have been sending in their ideas, have played the game all the way through. One person actually beat the entire game, and there really is no end to the game yet. There's not even, you know, I really only have two bosses done in the game. So, yeah, Pedro finished the whole game. And send in so much awesome feedback. So many little bugs and suggestions and stuff. Let's post to Facebook now, huh? Facebook. I just posted to TigSource. I'm also going to post to... I already posted to Twitter. What else starts with T? Tumblr. Here we go. Refresh this page, see if this GIF works now. Looks like we lost our mojo here. But I'm taking a screenshot anyway. Fine work. Fine work y'all have done here. Mighty fine. Does this work? Oh, look, it works now. All right, let's publish that little GIF on Facebook. Oh, Raybro! Nice one, dude. We beat the world record. We have beat the world record. No one else in the world is doing this, I'm telling you. There's other games like it, I'm sure, but there's no BC Warrior thing like this. We have set a world record. That's right. I'm going to contact Guinness Book of World Records. Oh, Artemis. We're only two away. This is legendary right here. Legends. Legends are born out of days like this. And let's post the gameplay trailer here too. I think this works, right? You can just post oh, love music! Yes! Epic. One more is all we need. You guys are good at this game. You guys are really, really on point today, I'm telling you. This is hard to do. Lots of you are sitting there going, oh, I just want to chat. I just want to comment something else besides a BC Warrior. But no, this strong-jawed, determined, you know what I mean? Yeah, let's post this. Publish. Publish that. Publish it to all the publishers everywhere. All right. Good. We got Facebook updated. Let's close out Facebook now. We got TigSource updated, but I do want to go in and start editing the page possibly today. So I might edit this in a second. So let's close this one. I think I posted everywhere that I'm going to need this big old GIF here. This is a big GIF. Oh, yeah, we got the end. Thank you. Don't let them get to you. But yeah, thank you, man. Yeah, I gotta put more links to the Steam page. Almost though, Ragathian. We almost had all the whole window filled up. But seriously, yeah, we set a world record there. There's really no reason to complain. Yeah, can I edit that on? I can bet I can. You're suffocating? What do you mean? Oh, yeah, let's post the link to the Steam page for sure. Yeah, good idea, Ragathian. I gotta always post the Steam page now that I have the Steam page. And I'm gonna start posting more on it, you know, like more art, be more active in the discussions there, post more announcements and stuff. I know it is 18. BC Warrior chat emulator. So yeah, let's edit this. No, not a reply. I don't want to edit. Oh, nice. You were suffocating with excitement. Right on. Oh yeah, Mightiness, thank you. Reddit, I need to be more active on Reddit. So this is the screenshot Saturday. SSS viewer, huh? All right. keep this link open here. Yeah, so for anybody just joining, today is entirely going to be a marketing day. I'm just sharing the marketing process of how an indie game developer would share their own game, and especially one that's solo. You know, this is a totally solo project, so I do the art, the music, the code, and the marketing. The marketing is a really big part of it. It's like, it's a daily thing, you know? It's very, very important to have the power to be able to market your own game and drive enough traffic to, you know, get sales and whatever else you're going to need to get for out of your game, you know, to be able to continue making games or whatever. Yeah, it's really important to be able to do that yourself and not have to rely on a publishing company or anybody else that's marketing, because a lot of times those kind of people, I don't know, in my experience, I've always had half-assed results from hiring out marketing. So, yeah, 9GAG. I haven't even seen 9GAG. Go fund yourself. Nice. All right. Yeah, no input nation. I'm guessing this has to do with, you know, marketing and publishing your own games. Well, what is no input nation? I gotta admit, I'm totally lost. I don't remember where I was, what I was posting to next. Oh yeah, I posted to Facebook. Oh yeah, I'm gonna post this GIF first to at least the this desktop is so crazy. I think this 15 here. No, not that one. This one. Yeah, so I need to make a smaller GIF. So I need to get rid of, there's 95 items in here. I need to get rid of half of them practically. Yeah, we'll leave it like that. Nice, right on. Cool, Loeb. Yeah, I like I said, I gotta get more active on Reddit for sure. I guess the only reason I haven't so far is it's just like, it's kind of like social network overload. I can only do so many social networks at once, being a one-man studio, you know. But I've posted on Reddit before, you know. I've done it. I just gotta start finding my niche and my groove on Reddit. Nice. Yeah, I hear ya. I agree. It's, at least for me, it's the same kind of thing. Marketing is always kind of a slow build. Yeah, right. Oh my God, this is an awesome story. Yeah. It's true. God, Steam Greenlight has become very important for indie developers. Sweet. Yeah, see, and this is a really, really great post because it's talking more about all of us rather than just him and his game, him or her. Yeah, it's so respectable. So I'm gonna make a GIF. Check out this GIF. Hopefully it's a little smaller than the last one. Where to go? I really gotta clean up my desktop, clean up my whole. Is my part of my mind here. You're seeing my cluttered mind. My mind is very cluttered this week. That's not bad. That's a small version of this graphic here. Nice. Wow. Top 100 on YouTube. Good goal, man. Yeah, nice. Way to go, Akuma. Big dreams. Big goals, dude. Big goals. It's awesome. Just by stating that you have a big goal means you're kind of a big person. You know what I mean? It takes a big person to have a big goal and to shoot for it. And what I'm trying to say is because you even have the thought of having that big goal, it does mean that it's possible for you. Your reality, you're bringing that into your reality and other people's reality too by setting those big goals. And just because you even have the inkling in your mind that you can hit that goal or even setting that goal, it means that you can hit it. You know, it's possible for you. So I'm gonna shrink it down a little bit here. Whenever I export a GIF with Photoshop, it shrinks it down a little bit. And to post onto Tumblr is such a bitch with GIFs. Like, even though Tumblr's limit is 3 megabytes, the most I've ever been able to get it to is 1.5 megabytes. Anything over 1.5 megabytes, and it screws up the GIF, and all of a sudden, sometimes the GIFs turn into just single screens, and you're like, what the hell happened to this GIF? So Tumblr, get your act together. Seriously. Get your GIF act together. Yeah. Right. Yeah, good, man. Good. Laughing. You like turtles? Nice. Yay. Me too. I like turtles. I like how turtles are like, they look like incredibly old the second they're born. So it's like, how do you really know how old a turtle is by looking at it? I'm not, can you know? Turtles are okay. All right, let's get this thing posted. Posted on Tumblr. Go. Mayhem small. Telling you, all this stuff needs to go. Oh, here it is. Boom, 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 boom. You count the rings, really? What about rabbits? Dude, who doesn't love a rabbit, huh? And penguins, yeah. I like monkeys. Oh yeah, this thing's really important. I got to update the trailer video here. This is I forgot to do this before this weekend. This whole page, I need to update all this. I want to make this the website for songbringer.com, the landing page here, have a lot more information about the game. like kind of like the a version, a smaller version of the Kickstarter page. You had a friend named nickname Rabbit? Cool. Yeah. You had a rabbit with a nickname Friend? That would be awesome. Post this new GIF here to the songbringer.com page. Oh, no, that's not it. Mayhem small. Here's the thing, you kind of cross your fingers every time you upload to Tumblr because you never know whether it's going to ruin your GIF or not even allow your GIF. No friends, no rabbits. But now you had. So this is past tense. What do you have now? Friends and rabbits, just friends. I think this is gonna work. Whoa, it's actually gonna work. That's crazy. You know, I'm definitely open to better hashtags I can use. If anybody knows how to do good hashtags on Tumblr, maybe pixel art. Sort of. GIF, yeah. Game dev, indie dev, maybe. Friends with rabbits. Like friends with benefits. You vote for a rabbit monster? Right on. Yeah. Rabbits are pretty friendly, right? They're social creatures. Songbringer. Sort of Zelda-like, I guess you could put Zelda as a tag. Not Zelda? Oh, I don't know how that not Zelda just came up, but that might be better than putting Zelda. Yeah, nice. Yeah, Ragathian, thank you, man. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, right, yeah. Just search for it. Okay, right, good point. Gotta put this link to the trailer and. No, I think the trailer, I'm gonna put it as a separate video, a separate post. Like pixel art, hyper rabbits. All right. We're putting on hype for rabbits. Yeah, you guys didn't know that's a thing? That's now a thing. Demon Rabbit. Oh, I know, right? Yeah. It's hard to decide. And you never know what somebody's gonna be working on, right? On these game dev streams. I never know what I'm gonna be working on. Okay, let's post this. What's up, Barkor? What's a hashtag? Is that really one of them? So on Tumblr, you can just search for hashtags. Oh, check it out. There's what's a hashtag. Gaming? Good call. Gaming? Dude, our core, it's going great, man. I posted the, Let's put that down. Gaming. I just posted this alpha gameplay trailer a little bit ago, so this is kind of what's been going on. Yeah, all week I've been just marketing the alpha version. And one of the biggest things I did for marketing was creating a new alpha trailer video. And So yeah, I'm definitely looking forward to getting some thoughts on it, how I can improve it for the next time I do the beta video. So there'll be a beta video, beta trailer, and then there'll be also be the final release trailer. So there's two more chances to get it even better. So I'm definitely looking for any thoughts. Mighty Explosion. What's a hashtag? So these are people, right? This first one. Nice. So let's do like, is game dev even like a tag? Is it really a thing? Bandygrass, what's up? I follow him on Twitter. What? This game looks like so much like Chicken Sword. Very Chicken Sword inspired. I guess game dev is a thing on here. Cool, check this out. Oh, it looks so. Crystalis for NES. This is a good tag. Keep this tag on here. Bots. Banyuza. RPG Zelda? Yeah. All right, cool. Let's post that one, and then I'm also going to post an actual direct link to the video. I hope that works. Video? Can I just. I want to add a video from the web. Nice, I can. Can tell I'm not super adept at all social networks. I'm still learning. Yeah. Post a link to the Steam page too. Yeah, not Zelda. But both Zelda and not Zelda, why not? Yeah. That's me, I'm an old man. I'm an old man. Trying to play with young men's toys. Come on, let's play with these toys. Try some other tags on this one. An experiment. Yes, right. Yeah, I'm a little kid at heart for sure. Feel like I always have been. Right, let's check this out. Let's see if this actually posted all right to the website. My songbringer.com is just a Tumblr page, so pretty easy to do your own blog. That's right. Oh, boo. That didn't work because probably it might be my website actually. My theme broke this. See if it actually put in the YouTube link for this. Yeah, we got div class video wrapper. We got an iframe. It's just not putting it in. Why is that? Video wrapper. Display block. Display block. Pound document. No. This even has a height. What happened to you? I feel like this should work. Oops, oops, oops. Does it work if I shrink it down? No, that didn't help. Right, you know what? I'm just gonna do it the easy way for now. I'm just gonna go back to my dashboard and put these links on the other post. Why Tumblr and not WordPress? I've originally always done WordPress for my blogs, for games and stuff. But this time I decided to try Tumblr because it's kind of cool that you can sort of build a following with it. I mean, you do the same thing with WordPress or whatever. You can totally build a following. But I guess I just really wanted to explore trying Tumblr and being like, is this a good place to find followers for a video game on Tumblr? And I'd say it kind of is, you know? I'm not really that popular on Tumblr yet or anything because I guess I'm just don't use it as much. What's up? Go to the dashboard. Yeah, you can. You can do custom CSS, cut you can even upload your own custom graphics to their servers. Okay, so let's get rid of this alpha gameplay trailer one post and we'll add to this post. So I'm gonna post a link to the alpha gameplay trailer and the Steam page. Save. There we go. Now we got a cool GIF and some links. All right, good. That's good enough. For now. Oh, but I do need to go and make sure and update the homepage here. So this video links to the new one. So I think that's in this icon here, settings. I want to edit the theme. It's polishing the inside of the screen right now. I like Tumblr. It's actually pretty cool. Actually, the edit HTML thing in Tumblr is really good. This is like the best, HTML editor I've ever used, just embedded inside a website. Really good. They're fine in search and replace, and everything in here is really, really awesome. Yeah, so here's the play vid function. All I need to do is put in a new code here. Do, save. No, I don't know. It's been there the whole year I've been using Tumblr. Yeah. It's just been here. I guess it's kind of buried, right? You got to get into your you edit your, you know, your theme, and then you click edit HTML. So it's kind of buried in here, but let's see if this works, this new video link. I embed Tumblr post tag Songbringer. What you mean? Did I do something wrong, or am I just not doing something I could be doing right? Look at that. You see that? You see how the text actually goes with the heartbeat of the song? Boom, 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 boom. There's a heartbeat all through this song. All right, cool. Yeah, we got a new video. Let's make sure this is the new video. Yeah, we got this green. This is all good. Sweet. Yay. Okay, so now all I got to do on this page is update the rest of it. But this is really important to have this, the trailer video updated here. So I will get to this later. Fixing up Tumblr, making the whole page better. That's good. We're done editing Tumblr for now. Oh, no. No, no, no. I don't. Oh, am I? Am I actually doing that? Good question, Turgis. I might actually be doing that. I thought it was only posts that I have tagged Songbringer, though. But I could be wrong. I totally don't understand Tumblr enough to say, is this just tags of Songbringer, or is this tags of, you know, other people tagging Songbringer, too? I don't know. This is kind of one of the drawbacks of Tumblr as well, is that they make it really inflexible about creating a multi-page site. Like, I have to have my blog page. You know, well, basically what I wanted was an about page just the beginning, right? Just songbringer.com. And then a blog page where it had all my GIFs and stuff. But they make it really hard for you to put your GIFs anywhere other than the home screen. So I've really had to kind of hack Tumblr's themes and stuff to get it to do that. What's up? Another bot? Bots. So many bots. Every day. Ever since TwitchCon. Ever since TwitchCon, there's been so many bots. Oh, you know what? I was going to update this. Steam page link. Thank you, Ragathian. Edit? I can't edit this anymore. Dang. Oh, modify. Here we go. Really? BTTV? Nice, dude. I need to get that then. Sure, you can see some of the code. What do you want to see, man? You want to see this code, that code, this code, that code, this code, that code. What's up, Lime Studios? Alright, let's add this, Steam page link. Yeah, marketing. Totally. I do think it's fun. And I think that's very important, too. What's up, R2? Yeah, I think marketing should be fun for you in your project. And in fact, if marketing is a chore or some kind of task like that that you just have to check off your list and it's just something you feel like you have to do, then I suggest you rethink everything that you know about marketing and get to the point where marketing is something fun for you to do. All right, Ekloff, good night, man. Good night, man. See ya. Wow. No thanks. What's up, Aid? Yeah, totally. Or you know what? For me at least, on when I first started, sharing Songbringer, I first had all these old thoughts about marketing, and I thought, marketing has to be this way or that way, and you have to be on all these social networks, and you have to blah, blah, blah. It was all just chores for me. And then I finally just decided, I want to have fun doing the marketing too. And for me, it became that way with Twitter. I'm like, dude, Twitter is actually kind of fun. And I kept my who I follow kind of low, on Twitter, so I can just follow the people that I really really want to see in my feed. That's one thing about Twitter is like if you're a serial follower, if you just follow other people hoping that they will follow you back, you're really being disgenuine, And so that also helps, right? If you're genuine with all your marketing, if you're just really genuine about what you're doing and sharing and stuff, goes a long ways. Pedro, what's up? Yo. Yes, right? Yeah, you would be bored doing marketing as a career, but surely you can find a fun way to market your own game. Yes, exactly. Keep talking and nobody explodes. No, I haven't seen that yet. You should post a link. What did you miss? I've just been marketing today, man. Real simple stuff. Oh, you did miss the world record. Let's see what. I think that was it, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's 17 right here. 17 right there, but I think there was 18. I don't know. My whole desktop's just full of stuff right now. Keep talking and nobody explodes. I love the sounds of this. I'm gonna have to explore this in detail later on rather than right now. Yeah. Yes, exactly. Right. Yeah. Games made by genuine feeling teams are the only games that I truly get pumped for. I totally agree with you there. No, our core actually, yeah, we got 14 the time before. This is the old record, right? Remember this one where we filled up the whole chat window? But this time I actually got the chat window bigger. So we have a huge chat window today. Biggest chat window I could possibly have on this screen. It was almost there. But you know what? That's a pretty good record for now. Let's go add the Steam link to the screenshot Saturday page too. Is it nice? Mesmerizing GIF. Those are the best kinds, right? Oh, check it out. It's already in my copy paste. Save that. Oh, you can hide the top menu bar? Oh. Wait, is there a way to do it on, you mean on here, on this window, or? How do I do that? Nice, right on. Oh, if you have El Capitan. Yeah, I still haven't done that. I got so much stuff to update and stuff like that on my computer. But I do that when I'm releasing, oh, cool, we got a reply already. Oh no, this is the screenshot Saturday page. Oh yeah, cool. I love checking out other games. You can find some really golden games and make some good friends on TakeSource. I really think TakeSource is an excellent place to be. It doesn't. Where'd he go when he after he fired the sword? Oh, you mean in that GIF? Where's that big one? Here it is. Oh yeah, right. You try and follow him. Dude, this is so fun. I'm telling you guys, I'm gonna make this one of the bosses or one of the mini bosses in the game. It's just fighting these huge hordes of enemies is freaking incredibly fun. So this is gonna be in the game. In fact, I'm actually kind of tempted to maybe go back and even update the alpha version with, a tiny minor update, but I don't know, that require a lot of testing, so tempting. It does? Damn. I love brew. I can't have my brew broken. Oh man. Right, where next? Where next? We posted to Facebook, we posted to TigSource, posted here to Tumblr. There's still a lot of updating to do on all these pages, but just getting the basics out with, links to this new trailer and stuff. Oh, IndieDB. Go to IndieDB. IndieDB is a great site. Also, if you want to market your own game, because IndieDB lets you post whatever you want about your game. So this is pretty cool. And you can also have your own CSS and, do your own thing and have, kind of get people to follow you. And in fact, when you post news about your game, it can be put on the front page of IndieDB, and that can get you a lot of attention. So IndieDB is pretty cool. Yes, hordes. It's your job to test, not mine. Oh man, thank you. Thanks for saying that. That really takes some weight off my shoulders. Because yes, I'm one of those people that really just wants to make sure the game's all perfected so much before I ever release it. Oh, check it out. I gotta update this link. This is definitely needs updating. Where the hell do I go? Edit. I think I'm just gonna go mess with this URL. I think it's games songbringer edit. That right? Yes, here we go. Really? Damn. Pseudo git? Dang. Oh. I'm definitely interested in hearing what you guys find about this, because I was just about to upgrade, like maybe early next week. What's up, Platformer Labs? Oh, you ran two updates and it works now? Cool. Itch.io, yeah, I haven't posted to itch.io or GameJolt yet, but both of those are on my list. Yeah, itch.io, GameJolt. Yeah, and Reddit. Those are like the three things I really kind of moving in that direction. But like I said, I really think marketing should be fun, so I don't want it to be too much of a chore. I don't want to, have to go on every site. So I guess, yeah, that's why I kind of have held off on doing those as of yet. Okay, let's get this URL updated here. Whoa. Oh, nice. Ah. I guess we should allow these, right? Game's probably going to be on Android. Hopefully Xbox, PS4. Definitely never web or flash. It would be sweet to put it out on SNES. Our Songbringer is taken? Really? Who took it? It doesn't seem to be anything here. Did I do it wrong? Oh, but it, oh, there's nothing here, but somebody did take it? Wow. Sweet. Oh yeah, there is an update for Xcode. Xcode 7, that's right. I got a lot of updating to do next week. Oh damn. Coco Studio X, yeah, Jonah. Yes, yeah, this R is just empty. Alright, well, I wonder who owns it. Is there some way to know? One reader. About one user here right now. I don't know. I can always do subreddit wizard foo or something else, but it'd be cool to do somber. Oh, we even post an image here. Yeah. It would be super cool. Yeah, so rad of them. And what's the other? There's a new game, Retro All-Star or something like that? There's a whole Kickstarter for some dudes that are making a game for NES, and they're documenting the whole process with the actual documentary movie. And they're sharing their source code for their game. So that's a pretty radness. Yeah. It doesn't compile on Android? What? There you go. I know, right? Yeah. What? Really? Those are so important. I'm gonna upload this this mayhem GIF. CGM Devoa. Ah. I will. I'll get in touch with this guy. Let me put a link to my desktop for that. Cool. We got this updated GIF. We updated the video here on this page. Lab Zero game? No, I haven't. Indivisible? Is this it? Oh, look how well this is done on Indiegogo. They've raised 200 grand in 5 days already. And it's a fixed funding goal. They're asking for 1.5 mil. That's dreaming big. What? Oh, really? Okay. Yeah, damn. Yeah, I think Marza was using YAML. Yeah. I know, right? Dude. Oh, yeah, that's probably what it was, Pedro. Yep. Maybe he's hoping it turns into something. Maybe he wants to actually be the person that maintains that. I don't really care to be the person that maintains it. I just want to, post to it sometimes. Yeah, this looks like a pretty dope team. Sort of like an ancient times game. Cartoony sort of. Total like Zelda cartoon vibe I'm getting from their art. Yeah, that's right. Really? Wow. Good for them. So they've been doing using Indiegogo. That's so crazy. I don't personally recommend using Indiegogo myself, but I don't know everything. This might be a dope niche for some people, some projects, Wow. Right, what's next? What's next? Okay, all right, still working on marketing stuff. What's next? We posted to IndieDB, and once again, here's a page I need to update. This whole IndieDB front page thing needs some new love. So I'll be working on that. Is this a link? That should be a link. Let's make that a link. Where did it go? All right, Marza, good night, man. I know how you feel. I was drinking last night too. Partying with some friends. It was great. It's great. Yeah, man. Yeah, get some Z's, dude. Good night and thanks for joining. Save this. There you go. That links the video. A new vid, new gameplay trailer. Bam. Okay, cool. So yeah, I'll get to updating IndieDB later on. Same thing with here with this not sombre.com homepage. 9GAG might be a possible place to share stuff. Screenshot Saturday Reddit. Might as well. I've never posted here, so let's do this. Let's do this. What's this SSS viewer though? Cool. So you can do GIFs on here, right? Beneath the tower. Looks cool. It's more like, yeah, it's kind of like a social network for indie game developers that you can just post whatever you want. So you can just go sign up, get a page, And yeah, post about your game. You can post news, images, videos. It's like it's its own deal. And when you post news, you can actually get listed on their front page. And whenever you do get listed on their front page, you don't get, you're not guaranteed if you post a news article that you will get featured on their on their homepage. But if you do an actual good post with enough images and you follow their guidelines and stuff, you usually will get listed on their homepage. And that will really make your traffic boost up on IndieDB for, for a good 3 days or so. Soul Appeaser, this game looks sweet. So these can be gifts, right? I'm pretty sure you can have gifts on here. Yeah, of course, man. Yeah. Heck yeah, that's what I'm here for. I live for these moments where I'm like, oh yeah, I helped somebody today. Nice. Find out these tips, where to post about your game. I really recommend Tig Source. Tig Source is an excellent place to be posting about your game because you not only are you going to find some other great games out there, but you're going to find other people that are making games sort of in your genre too. You'll make actual friends on there with other people doing what you do. And that's, yeah, that's awesome. Rogues with benefits. So let's check out this one here. Check it out, they won an award. Oh, cool. Oops. This is the one screenshot. Check us out and come die with your friends. Right, let's do this. Post something. This isn't our game dev. I thought that was supposed to be in our Yeah, what's that? The whole 25 hits. Yeah. That's what's great about Reddit, you can tell them. Like, hey, yo, I like your art. I think it could be better too. Okay, yes, this is our game dev. So I wonder if this whole SSS thing pulls in from game dev as well as Screenshot Saturday. Oh, Akuma, really? So when you're looking at your viewer count on Twitch, you mean? Oh, wow. Interesting. So you have to be logged in to log the views. It's kind of interesting. Adventure Desert puzzle game. You seek the rod as well? It is hidden deep in these lands. Cool. I like this whole mysterious, simple, low poly look. I love that. Possibly. You never know. Yeah, Future Love Space Machine. What's this one? This is like the Leisure Suit Larry of sci-fi. Okay, let's do this. Let's post. Let's post something to this screenshot Saturday. Reddit. I always gotta read their guidelines first though, because I get. Oh wait, okay, so we got wait. Oh, this is game dev. Oh. That's I've never posted to game dev. I really gotta do this. Yeah, true, right? Did I click your link yet? Check it out. Was this from last video or something? Or did you post it today? That screenshot was terrifying. So I thought Reddit had its own screenshot Saturday. Is that, am I just totally wrong about that? Oh no, so you just post, you add on your comment right here. Yeah. Tusken tiger skins. Okay, so your this is daily discussions for game dev. Right. General programming, discuss your game. This scroll bar is messing with me. Oh, will you send it again? Sorry, man. As you can see from my current state of desktop, I am behind on a few things here. This is kind of how stuff gets when I'm releasing a version of the game, you know? It's like I got all this art and all this tons of marketing materials. It's just all disorganized, so my apologies, man. Cool. This is basically game dev guidelines. Feedback Friday. Screenshot Saturday, use to show off your game. Soundtrack Sunday? Oh, wow. Marketing Monday. Hey, I didn't know that was a thing. Marketing Monday. Use to ask and exchange information about marketing business. I think that's really, really important. Cool. Oh my God, I got to get on here with Marketing Monday a little bit. And Soundtrack Sunday. I got a lot of new sounds to share. Yeah, I know. Yeah, I got the classics for. And then, you know, today's run. There's another one somewhere here. At least this one. Yeah, this is it. This is how close we got today to a full screen. Watch the animation of all that stuff. Oh, Kane's story? Oh, I have to agree. Yes, I'm an adult. I can read this. Dude, you're a good writer, man. I feel like I'm taking up other people's time though here on the on reading it on the live stream, but yeah. Sorry, I got to put it on my desktop again to watch later. But I will tell you that I'm usually pretty good at getting everything off my desktop. So, some point during this week, I will have read the story. And I love this character, dude. So Akuma's got a sweet concept. If anybody's interested in this character called Kane, this sort of interdimensional traveler, you should check it out. Because he's such an interdimensional traveler that he can travel into your game as well. Don't ask for legal advice. Don't ask to do your work, right? Okay, cool. So I'm gonna post here as a reply to this screenshot Saturday. All right. Do I need a new a title? How did they get titles on theirs? You tell I don't use Reddit that much. Dr. Dread. Oh, they're not even adding a title. They're just adding a big bold piece right here. So we'll call it Songbringer. Procedurally generated Zelda-like. Sci-fi Zelda-like. Yeah, cool. That's awesome, man. So, is your focus more on the book or on the games? Spam, third spam of the day. Deleted. Listen for any help. Oh, cool. We got some nice markup. Markdown. Markdown up, down, down, left, right, start, select. I know, hell yeah. Back in bats. I'm just gonna post some simple stuff here, just some links. I don't know that much about game dev on Reddit, so I'm just gonna post some two links. That's it for now. Right on. Oh, really? Rez? Thanks, Solar Flare. Yeah. Yeah, quote me on that one. That'd be great. I love it. Really? Oh, okay. It's a little da oh, yeah, to make it a header. Cool. So not the So does that actually work? It's not showing it on here, but let's see the whole instructions. Yeah, awesome. Oh yeah, so it is right. Okay. Oh yeah. Quotes, tables. Right, it doesn't even say on this page, but oh well. I trust you guys. Yeah, I would assume that's a header, right? But it would give you bigger text. Awesome. Okay, let me get this whole link. Reddit. Yeah. I'm just looking at Reddit right now, posting on our game dev screenshot Saturday, the latest screenshot Saturday. Yeah, nice, man. Yeah, totally. If you can get one of them to make enough of a living for you, you're golden, because you have such a deep character there that you're creating a whole franchise in essence with how well you're developing that character. Kane. Yo, what's up, Pete and Wally? Definitive Reddit add-on. Sweet. Thank you, guys. Thanks for always helping me improve. I'm glad to help you guys improve your whatever you're doing, your game and stuff. But a lot of times you guys are just teaching me stuff, so thank you. Okay, where are we at? Yeah, let's get this. We got a header. It's like a H1, right? Let's post this link to the trailer. A GIF. I guess I'll do the Giphy GIF. Whoa, man, look how old these are. I want my newest GIF, not all these GIFs. Seriously, old school. Old school. Where's my new school stuff? Alright, I just posted it on the. Is this it? No, that's an old one. These are all old. Alright, let's grab it from the TIG source page. It's got a link. Do I ever plan on making a game with a team? I have done this before in the past, and you know, my last game, for example, I made with my buddy, so we were a two-man team. But how would I handle branding at that point? That's a really good question, because I don't know. I've never really done a game with others where I've actually successfully marketed it. You know, the last game that we did, I totally did the wrong thing, and we wrote the whole game, never ever marketed anything. And I learned my lesson the hard way that, dude, you gotta do your own marketing. No one else is going to do marketing for you. A company you hire at the last minute is going to not be able to do very good results. You know, so yeah, I would say this is of utmost importance, how you handle branding and marketing, and whether you're having fun with it, whether you're being genuine about it. And so someone in the team would have to be that person that has... that does the marketing every day. You know, it's a daily thing. You got to be doing something to share your game. So I guess I would talk with my team, and we'd figure out who's the one that's going to do that. Wasabi? Oh, nice. Right on. My last game, it's called Hero Bash. It's like a MOBA for iOS. Hero Bash. That's the old server. Hero Bash. Yeah, it's like a brawler MOBA game. Sort of like it's like Legend of, League of Legends, but with cartoon characters, basically. So yeah, this game took us a year and a half to make, and we just didn't market it very well. So it never really took off. But now that I've learned my lesson, I'll never make that same mistake twice, you know? You gotta share your game. No one's gonna do it for you, and hiring someone is just not gonna work. Usually. Senpai! Yeah, I can do all the work. Are you gonna keep all the money? Right on. But you know what? You guys might actually be able to profit from this game because there will probably be mods, and Steam allows you to sell your mods these days. So maybe you could write a cool mod for Songbringer and make your own story, make your own characters or whatever, and boom, make some profit without having to code a single line. Yes, yeah, point comma null, exactly. Sometimes there's nice indie games no one knows because they didn't do marketing very well. And it's not that hard. You know, it's really not that hard. Like, for example, this is marketing right here. I'm on Twitch, just talking to y'all. And I'm not even trying to market anything. But this ends up being good marketing. You know, that's some of the best marketing out there is when you're not even focused on marketing, whatever the hell that's supposed to mean. You're just sharing from the heart, you know? Right? Dual branded, yeah. Right. Member 7, yes, yeah, we could have, but I hadn't learned my lesson until I got to this phase of starting this new game, Songbringer. So I kind of started everything from scratch with Songbringer, and I was like, I got to figure out a way to make marketing fun for myself. And so I tried out social networks a lot when I first started this game, and I was like, you know what? I really like Twitch and I really like Twitter. Those I can see myself really, really pushing hard. Not really pushing hard, but like just daily kind of doing things with. So, yes, and in fact, I think we could still go back and do Hero Bash again. Like if I remarketed it or sort of like started to build a following for it, did some more development for it, you know, it could be a success. And in fact, I think it's kind of one of those things on my list where I'll probably go back at some point in life and redo it. So yeah. Really? They dropped it? Oh. Wow. Yes. All right. Totally. Random success is not really a thing. It's all, yeah, it's so much underground work involved in all successes that you ever see. You know, no one succeeds overnight. That is such a freaking myth. You know, total myth. No one succeeds overnight. The people that you see who you think are succeeding overnight, they have been working for months and years before that to make that moment happen. And, you know, they're just dedicated people. They're usually smart people too, but like dedication is just finishing what you started and things like that. All right. Well, cool. I know maybe mods aren't a thing anymore on Steam. Yeah. How hard is it to get interviews with game journalist websites? Oh wow, cool. So you just found the game yesterday? Awesome, man. Cool. Yeah, you know what? This is such an awesome thing. I didn't ever reach out to Kotaku or pretty much any of the other people who wrote articles about Songbringer when it was first on Kickstarter. So how hard is it to get interviews and people to review your site and stuff like that from journalists in the game industry? It's really not that hard as long as you're sharing on in a kind of a grand way. Like when you're on Kickstarter, you're gonna get a ton of attention from the game journalists. And same thing when you put your game on Steam Greenlight. So my advice for if you want to get tons of articles written about your game and get yourself on Steam and get funded for your game too. What you got to do is first build up enough of a prototype where you really think you could create a dope video. It's the best video of gameplay, right? You need at least enough game where you can film a great video. And then you're ready for, I think at that point, as long as you built up a following during the process of creating the prototype of your game, I think you're ready for a Kickstarter at that point, you know? You have a decent following, you have a prototype of your game, you have a great video, it's time for a Kickstarter. And a Kickstarter will just put you in front of the entire industry. The people like game journalists, they're searching. They're looking for places and games that they can write articles on. So they're gonna find you almost as much as you're trying to find them. And I never, like I said, I didn't reach out to any of them. They just wrote articles about the game because they found it on either Steam Greenlight or Kickstarter. And both of those I did at the same time. So it just kind of really was a synergistic thing. And yeah, I got lots of articles written. And now those people that wrote articles already about it, they know about this game. And so now that I'm publishing this new alpha gameplay trailer, maybe I will actually go and reach out back to them and say, hey, there's a new version. Do you want to play it? Here's the game code. And here's the new video and stuff like that. Oh, right. Yeah. Good point, member seven. Right. Yep, Minecraft. Some people say it just succeeded overnight, but Team Fortress 2 was plugging them, and that's how they exploded. Wow, I didn't know they totally stopped allowing those paid mods. That's crazy. Dystopia, what do you think of the mailing list where gaming journalists blacklist game developers? Do they really do that? I had never heard of that. Oh, you found it through Eurogamer. See, either way, yeah, that's awesome. And I'm really hoping for that for when the beta version and especially the final release, I really will do the biggest marketing push of all, and I will probably contact a lot of people. By hand, I'll go and email. Almost everyone I think would like this game and the game industry, game journalist type people. I'm gonna do a huge push when I finally release this game. So, whoa. Dang, yeah, $100, yeah. Yeah, wow. Game Informer? No, I haven't. But that's one I should add to the list, right? So I that's also a good thing. If you're marketing your own game, and especially when you're reaching out to game journalists or they're reaching out to you or writing articles about your game, keep a spreadsheet of it all. You know, keep a spreadsheet of like the name of the journalist. You know, or the name of the journalist's website, or their, you know, like Eurogamer or Kotaku or whatever. And then you also want to keep track of their Twitter, their email, links to articles they've written about you, notes maybe, you know, just a simple little spreadsheet like that. Because sometimes it's so easy to get lost in the actual game development, and then you come back to the marketing and you're like, wait, who was I supposed to email again? So it's really nice to have that, you know, spreadsheet of it all. So Game Informer, that's one of the ones I need to add to my spreadsheet. I think I might have actually. No, I don't think I reached out to these guys. Wow. Really? I had never heard of this dystopia. Wow. Wonder why they would do. Why would they blacklist game developers? This like seems very counterproductive. Burt Reynolds, Gator. Yeah. Yeah, totally. Right? Isn't it counterproductive of somebody to blacklist the people that are trying to get stuff for them to write about? You know, their whole job is to write stuff. Why would they want to blacklist people that are gonna? I mean, probably this. It's a blacklist because it's just noise or whatever, or shitty games or something. I don't know. Here we go. Here's the freaking GIF. Giphy. Now, where was I posting this? Oh, screenshot Saturday. GIF. Bam. And Steam page. On Steam. Yeah, totally, right? Oh, cool. So Game Informer has an indie game. Sweet. Yeah, I just did Google it and I got this page or that page. What are these pages? But I saved a link. I'm gonna check that out. Oh, could be misleading practices. Yeah. That's a no-no for sure. And that goes back to being genuine about everything you do, you know? Just be genuine. I think you're gonna probably avoid being on a blacklist if you're just being a genuine person on the internet. You know, you're not trying to game the system. You're not trying to reach too far. You know, there's like, you're not trying to be greedy. You're just being, you know? Yes, having a good press kit is essential. Yes, oh, I should mention that, right? So in addition to building up a prototype of your game and building up a following and getting ready for a Kickstarter and a green light, you do want to have a press kit, right? Just really easy and ready. And this is the press kit for Songbringer, and it's really grown over time. At first, I had only like two screenshots. I had no videos. No one had written articles about the game. But it's okay. Just get your page up about it and start it out. And then once you do a Kickstarter, man, you're gonna in or Steam Greenlight, you're gonna have tons of people write about your game. You're probably gonna have tons of great screenshots by then. You're gonna have a link to a good trailer. So your press kit's gonna grow. And here's the link to get a press kit for your own game. See this, the guys from Vlambeer, the Dutch guys that do Nuclear Throne. They did this dopresskit.com, which allows you to do your own press kit for your game. What up, Vlad? Wow. Yeah. Man. I think we're ready to post here to Reddit. Is there anything else I should post on this Reddit? I mean, I'm really just gonna try and keep it simple here for this very first post I'm ever doing to our game dev. I got a GIF, I got a gameplay trailer, Steam page. Short description of the game. I think this is good. Yeah, Solar Flare, I do streams pretty much every day. I take a few days off per week, and it's totally random. I'm really, really random about when I do it. But I do usually do between 2 and 4 p.m. Pacific time. That's usually about when I'm starting to stream. So late afternoons, Pacific time is when I start. And it's almost every day. It depends on the week, you know. So the best way to actually catch my streams is to follow here on Twitch, because you never quite know when I'm going to go online. Yeah, true, true. You don't have to use dopresskit.com. You're pissed and frustrated? Why's that? What happened? Yeah, I should read. Yeah. Let's do that. So here, I'm gonna make sure I don't lose this. Wise advice, Pedro. Let's check out our. this is a great one where they're talking all about their game and stuff, but I kind of want to just keep it simple for this first post and only just do a few lines. Here's a totally different one. Where does it show how many people have voted up? I thought it showed that, right? Did none of these get any vote ups? Am I logged in? Yeah, I'm logged in. Oh, man. Oh, dude, you got some more tension over there again? Oh, no naked links? Good call. Sort by top? Oh. Where is that? Sort by top. I'm such a newbie to Reddit. It's gotta be at the top, right? Sort by top? Sort by anything? Sort by? Where art thou? Sort by? Oh, here. Sorted by. Thanks. Sorted by link. Oh, so yeah, there you got 14 points or whatever. Foogle, 3D voxel game. Cool. Yeah, I like this, where they're just doing a simple, very short description of their game. Wizard of Legend. Cool name. Thanks for following, you guys. Okay, yeah, let's do a better post now. Let's do Songbringer, and then Songbringer is a procedurally generated Zelda-like game set in a sci-fi universe. Recently released is a closed alpha version with a new gameplay trailer. So I'm assuming this is just all marked down. Yeah, that's probably why I like it, right? Dude, right? Life in the Holy Land. Man, tense, dude, it's tense. I've been there very briefly. So yeah, I've seen the walls, I've seen the barbed wire, I've been on both sides of the wall. I've been in other countries in the Middle East, right around. And yeah, it's good to have been there. To really give it some actual weight, you know, some actual, but yeah. Long time strife, right? Long time. Wait, did I do these links right? Yeah. Shang. Cool. Yeah, that's time to do this. Link to the site? Well, I want to focus more on the Steam page for the next like 3 months, really. I want to really make that the page that I'm shooting to promote. Oh yeah, postings to Twitter. I guess Twitter would work. Yeah, it's always good. Okay, let's do these. The game was successfully kickstarted. Is that an uppercase verb? I mean, adverb. And greenlit on Steam. So I can at least do at Wizard Foo. Post a link to a cute kitten staring out of a ceiling tile. Pandalita, yes, I'm Matthew McConaughey. What's up? Welcome to the live stream, game development. I know Matthew McConaughey. I've always been seen in some great movies, but today I'm decided from now on I'm gonna be a game developer. So no more movies. Sorry, y'all. Whoops. I need some light. It's dark in here. Yeah. Yeah, I agree, totally. But I think these are okay, right? A link to the video, a link to the Steam page, a recent GIF, and Twitter's cool too. You know, it's not like too overwhelming or anything. Right, ready to do this? Let's do this. 6 a.m. Java, yep, standing. Greenland, no uppercase? Oh, dude, damn. Can I edit my post? I can. Nice. Right, cool. Let's see if they did it to the this SS thing. Does it post my GIF? It might just post pings or whatever. Because, yeah, I don't see any of these as actual animated GIFs showing up. So I probably should have done a ping file too, but oh well. I'll get that right some other time. Oh, it updates every 5 minutes. Oh. Yeah. Nice, nice Pedro. Nice. So yeah, I'm just doing marketing today. Totally doing that for the stream today. Man, you guys have already helped me out a lot, dude. I got on Reddit finally, on Reddit's game dev. I've never done that before. I've updated. You know, here's a good one. I should update the Twitch page. There's new screenshots. Put some of these new screenshots up. What's up with this window? Why is it? Okay, yeah, totally. Yeah, I can link the Reddit post. Think is it. Y'all go. Yeah, so I'm gonna spiffy up the Twitch page, Twitch info here. The info you guys can click on right now. I'm gonna update it. Oh, you know what? Has this been? There's some important links I have to update here. No, actually, these are okay. Yeah, these are good. I like all this, but the images needed updating. Oh, Vlad, yeah. Okay, you're the second person to say that. Mightiness said the same thing. So, kind of right. So in Songbringer, you can only move up, down, left, or right, and you can't move diagonally at all because first of all, it's an homage to Zelda 1, but it's also a design decision. When I first started making the game, I had diagonal movement, and you can see in my input system and everything, there's still the possibility for diagonal movement. So right, I can allow certain directions. I can allow south, southwest, west, or whatever. And so I can add some flags to any input component to allow all movement in diagonal directions as well. So the player, I could easily make him be able to walk diagonally again. So I think I might try that out, right? It's worth experimenting with because I tried it out very early on in the game and I did not like the diagonal movement. It just really messed with the flow and the feeling of the game. So I'm open to trying it again though. So that's one thing I need to try. So thanks, Vlad. Have I made any experiences with bigger YouTubers? No, not yet. Yeah, totally. I'm sure there is. I'm sure there's money involved. But yeah, I guess not really the huge YouTubers, but Button Masher Bros and Button Masher Bros are pretty big, right? Why didn't this link to their YouTube? There you go, Button Masher Bros. How many followers do they have? So they almost have 1,000 followers. They're pretty, dude, these guys are hilarious. I love the Button Masher Bros. You gotta check out their videos, they're hilarious. But also, Randomized User. Dude, he's great. I love Randomized User. So both these guys have written about, or not written about, but done videos about Songbringer. And they did videos so long ago, back in the Kickstarter phase of the game when it was just how would I view this as fire safety. Oh
Randomized
yeah, he's got
users,
2,000
indie gaming.
followers. Right? Minecraft is an interesting case study about marketing. Oh, why isn't it showing me the trend for this? Oh, probably because it added the word coincidentally here. Yeah, totally. Look at this. So yeah, Minecraft was when did Minecraft start? First video started in 2009. Yeah, but look at it. Boom. 0000000000 meme. Yeah, very interesting case study for sure. Team Fortress 2, one of the most successful games ever. And they did write about Minecraft in 2010. Wow. This is before Notch was big. Can you believe that? The word of Notch. He's been getting a lot of crap for people telling him he's a sellout lately, which sucks. But I think whatever movie he's gonna make, good for him. Yeah. Oh, it does make movement strategic in tight rooms. Oh, P. Wally, interesting. Okay, so it's for you, it's mainly when you're trying to aim at enemies. Let me focus on this. This is the part where maybe I still don't allow diagonal movement, but maybe there's a better way you can aim at enemies, you know? Yeah, this is definitely needs to be addressed here. Yeah. Yes, he did. Oh, yeah. I mean, before I even got yours, I had already had like 120 or something crazy. Look how many bugs there are on this list right now. All right. So if I just even take away those two empty lines, I've still got 128 lines of stuff and yours to add. I basically have to so much work to do to just like get myself back to a clean desktop, a clean brain really is what I need right now. But yeah, so there's gonna be like 20 more bugs I'm sure added to this list, and then I'm gonna ignore all these for a little while. And focus on creativity and stuff. But I will get back to these. That's why they're on the list. Ah, bot. Ben, thou bot. Metallica and Iron Maiden making it big without the number one marketing source for musicians' bands, radio. Yeah. They're still making it big somehow, though, you know? Yeah, you should check us out. If anybody that's like look how freaking awesome of a job Pedro's done. Where did I put it? Here it is. Look at how detailed this is. Look at this. So Pedro played the entire game. I think he's the first person to ever complete Songbringer. I certainly haven't done it. I've only played like an hour and a half game once where I got to three levels deep. So look how organized this whole list of thoughts and comments and ideas and just things that are sort of unintuitive, minor bugs, major bugs. Thank you. Thank you for such a really detailed report and great feedback, man. Thank you. Yeah. Oh yeah, try your controller for sure. Yeah, new stuff. Yes, I can't wait too. Yeah, and so oh my God, the one thing I'm really stoked to make is this spirit guide. So I've decided you're gonna have all these chi powers. So you're gonna or not chi, it's more like skills. So you're gonna be able to develop skills from you find this spirit guide. He's on the overworld, and you find him in a really tricky way, and he becomes your spirit guide, and he starts to teach you things. So you can learn to tuck and roll. So like you'll be able to like tuck and roll, dodge things. You get all sorts of just simple skills from him, from training with him on the map. And some of them are going to be chi skills. Like you actually use your chi power or whatever, your bio energy to do stuff. Yeah, 5 hours, 40 minutes. Yeah, oh yeah, letter seeds work without all six letters, but what's behind the scenes going on is the game actually uses those first five letters to seed the random number generator, and that sixth letter is added based on those first five letters. So it's still deterministic, it's still a six-letter seed, even if you do enter a five-letter word. So that's why I'm always asking for a whole six-letter word on the stream when I do those playthroughs, because I just want to make it clear, I guess there's six letters, but I don't know. Nice. The next one's gonna be second. Nice. I'm so glad the controllers were good this version. Yeah, it's nanotech. All right, P. Wally, see you, man. Yes, it should. Yep. All right, so where am I? What am I doing now? What am I doing? Oh yeah, updating images. Get these images updated. This update. Oh, look, it worked. Songbringer, bam. Even though it's a GIF, it posted a single frame of it. That's nice to know. Cool. Okay, yeah, so let's update these screenshots on the Twitch channel. And then I think I'm gonna be done for today's stream. I am really lazy today. I stayed up all the way till sunrise last night. Saw the sunrise over the ocean. Man, it was so beautiful. So beautiful. Yeah, every room is randomly generated. Yes, yeah, the every element of the room is actually randomly generated or procedurally generated with algorithms and stuff. Yeah, totally. Yeah, so we'll have specific testing periods. Yes, definitely. This is one of them, right? This is the alpha testing period. People have sent in a lot of great feedback on the alpha phase. And then the next one's going to be beta, which will be, either December or January. And so there'll be a whole phase that hopefully by then the beta version is really, really dialed in. There's a lot less bugs and it's a much more feature complete game by then. So you're highly interested in testing processes. Oh yeah, of course. Yeah, of course I have needs for testers, for sure. The best way to do that is just to it's all closed testing at this point. So really the only people that are testing it are people that have pre-ordered the game. So by pre-ordering you get your name in the main menu anyways. Sometimes you can even get your name in gold if you're one of those kind of backers. Yeah, so if you do want to test, you can pre-order the game and be one of the closed testers. So that's just kind of how I've done it for this game. But a lot of people these days are actually doing their alpha versions and beta versions totally free, and just opening it up to whoever's gonna. And that's also has some merit, right? Just doing a free demo version or a free alpha version, free beta, because you're gonna build a following that way too. You're gonna find some incredible backers of your game that are gonna like love it and help you with it and stuff. Yeah, exactly. That's what Songbringer does. So it adds on a sixth letter. Now, what's up, Steve? Yeah, it was so nice. My God, my eyes, I could still see it. It was so amazing. How many bug reports from, oh man, 10 or so. Ekloff even did a video bug report. That was cool. But yeah, I mean, just any kind of bug reports are great to get because it's, these are important things that need to be addressed. Probably the biggest bug of the alpha version was the stupid VC redist things. So I do need to include all the DLLs, I think, in the actual build of the game so it doesn't crash on Windows or like not even start on Windows and people have no clue why it didn't even start because it's stupid. Dude, I totally blame Microsoft. Fitz, there will not be pre-orders available through Steam, because for that you have to actually do. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I'm pretty sure that on Steam you have to do what's it called? Early access. You have to be on early access to be able to actually pre-order the game on Steam. I think I'm right about that. I don't know, So yeah, I'm planning. I really don't want to do early access, so I plan on actually just releasing the game on Steam. So for now, the pre-orders are available through Humble Bundle. So it's all Humble Bundle. So you're gonna get a Steam code, anyways. But it's just the sales go through Humble Bundle. And what's cool about Humble Bundle is they actually give to charity a portion of everything that they make. So that's pretty cool. But yeah, if anybody's interested in pre-ordering the game, it's on Sombrio.com pre-order. Making the camera follow you rather than your camera shifting whenever you leave the screen in the overworld. Solar flares. This is a really good question, right? It's a very I'm already entrenched, if you could say, in the concept of not having the camera follow the player. Because this is meant to be a game like Zelda 1, the very first Legend of Zelda, where the I loved that. I loved that about Zelda 1, where you this the game never ever scrolls. There's no scrolling. Simple, right? Simplicity. And that's really what I'm trying to go back to with this Sombrio game, is going back to the raw simplicity of Zelda 1. And I love the fact that it, as you move off the screen, then it shifts. But other than that, it never ever allows the camera to move. And I do see the benefits, right, to use to having a camera follow the player and allowing scrolling, right? That's pretty cool. It makes your world bigger, right? But no, it really, in fact, I've designed this game from the ground up to be this way, and it would probably take me 6 months just to rework the whole game into a scrolling game. So interesting suggestion, and maybe I'll keep that in mind for like Songbringer 2 or 3 or something. But for now, I'm really gonna stay with this whole single screen look and feel. Yeah, cool. Yeah, alphas definitely teach you a lot, right? I know, it was too much of a pain. Yeah, totally. The DLLs on Windows were just a real bad thing. In fact, I'm considering updating the alpha version this week when before I do a put. I still haven't even pushed the alpha version out to YouTubers or anyone on Kickstarter yet. So there's still a lot of marketing. I'll probably be marketing till Monday or Tuesday. And some of that will include updating the alpha version. So I'm pretty much going to take the DLLs and just put them right in the freaking ver in the package. So if you're missing MSVCR120.dll or whatever, it's already there in the game's package. You don't even need to install the VC Redis to have it work. And I think I can figure out how to do that on my system if I just uninstall all the Redists and then try it. C sharp over C++. I really think this is a personal thing, you know? C sharp over C++. It really, and it's also an engine thing. You know, your like Unity's gonna use C sharp. So if you want to use Unity, definitely learn C sharp. C sharp's got some great benefits. It's a higher level language than C++. C++ is a little lower level, meaning you have to do more manually. So if you're a student game developer, I would explore both of them. I would explore both of these languages a little bit. Do some simple tutorials with both of them and kind of get a feel for what you prefer. Because one of them will probably reach out to you. In fact, C sharp is pretty rad. You don't have to use headers. There's a lot of advancements they've made. But C++ is a little more portable. It's a little more fast. So those are huge benefits right there, portability and speed. Yeah, right. Yeah. Yeah, Unreal, that's a good point to mention. Unreal supports C++, which is a, you know, top-notch engine. Nice, right on. Good for you. Yeah, here's some good advice too. Learn C. You should almost learn C before you learn either of these, C sharp or C++, because C is the foundation for both of them, and C will teach you almost everything you need to know. Pretty much, you know, well, it's gonna teach you the basics. You're gonna know pointers and stuff that you just, if you're gonna be a programmer, you know, of games or whatever you're programming, you need to know some C. Try assembly. You're badass if you can code in assembly. I mean, it's a whole different type of, it's more stack based. Okay, back to these updating these images. Like this one, old. Replace this image. Pointers. Oh, sad face. Yeah. Pointers can be tricky at first. When You trying to figure it out, you know? Yep. It's basically just the address of a variable in memory. It's really all a pointer is. You're dereferencing it to get at the content of the memory at that address. And so there's two ways to look at a pointer. You can dereference it and get the data, or you can treat it as it is, which is still an address. So it's really, they're quite fascinating and powerful and dangerous. Yeah, I agree. I agree. Well, object-oriented programming is really not the best way to create games, and I don't think anymore. Component-based systems are much preferable. You want to use an entity component system. Yeah. And if you're using Unity, that's what's so great about Unity, is that you're already using an entity component system. Everything in Unity is already components. And you can get a good feel for how games are developed with entity component systems by using Unity a little bit. Nice, dude, you made an ASCII Space Invaders game in ASM. Yeah, Thits, yes, you do. Yeah. As you get on Steam, well, first you gotta yes, so when you actually get greenlit, this is when this happens. At first on Steam, you just have a Steam user account, right? And then you pay him $100 to be able to do a green light. I think that's a great thing. You know, you don't want to have everyone in the freaking world doing a green light. So it's good to have at least that $100 barrier, but it's a one-time thing. You only have to pay your $100 once, and you can post as many green lights as you want. So after you get greenlit, that's when they reach out to you and they say, "Hey, congratulations on getting your game greenlit. Let's get all the legal stuff handled." And so they get your actual game name, your legal information, your business, and all that. You basically sign a contract. There's a confidentiality agreement and stuff. So yeah, that's kind of what happens when you get greenlit on Steam. That's true. Right? Yeah. Component based. It's more of a game. No, entity component systems could be used for pretty much any kind of programming, I think. But they're really more for games. It's more of a game thing. Yeah, check it out. Here's a great starting article. Ray Wunderlich's Entity Component System. This is the one I kind of learned from, and I had to actually read this article two or three times before I really kind of got it. Oh, does it really? That's cool. Yeah, data oriented. Yep, totally. Components basically. If you do entity component systems right, all an entity is a single integer that represents the number of that entity. All your components are is data. There's not intended to be any code in your components. Systems are where all of the code happens, right? That's the breakdown of what an entity component system is, right? And it's kind of like MVC in a way, is whereas you're separating data from your view and your controller, right? It's the same thing with entity component system. Very powerful because you're using composition to create your entities rather than inheritance, which is very brittle, and you're having to write so with OOP, you're having to write so much code to do the same thing you could do with a component much more simply. What's the difference between OOP and entity? Yeah, I hope that description I gave right there was the answer you're looking for. Basically, OOP is hierarchical design. Components are composed, and that is way easier to take off a piece. If you've got an entity that's coded as this hierarchical model, right? Your game is all OOP. You've got a character object. Underneath that, you've got a player object. You've also got another class called AI. And underneath AI, you have enemy one and enemy two and enemy three. You've got this whole brittle system, right? And to create a new bit of code in that is tough, because if you want to go update the parent class, right? If you want to go update your parent class, okay, let's say I want all my characters to be able to do something else, and you add all this code to the character class. Guess what you got to do? You got to go test every single freaking subclass. It's such a pain in the ass to code with Oop that way. And with entity component systems, you're composing. So you can easily have an entity with all these different components in it. You can take out one component. You can make sure one component works really well, independent of others. Very powerful. Very, very powerful. Yeah, yeah. Exactly. State is essentially the component, right? The state of the entity, the data of the entity. And then behavior happens in the system. The system is the one that does the code, right? Entity is just an integer. Component is data. And systems are where all the code is, basically. It's another link. Oh, yeah. Sorry to watch this one. Yeah, they are in design. Nice. So, dude, really? Cool. Oh, man. What languages are good for components? Any language. Yeah, any language. It really doesn't matter what language you're writing in to create an entity component system. You could do it in any language, literally. Whoa, you started coding at 8? Damn, dude. That is early. You'd like deserve a blue star for that or something. A gold star. What the hell is that uploading? Oh, right, these new images. Should I do this one? This one's kind of cool. This one, maybe? Yeah, let's do that one. Whoa, whoa. I can't even see the whole window with these big images. This is crazy. Here you go, 1080p. This is really necessary. Let's test this image. Let's make sure this image didn't break everything. Here we go. Submit. Yeah, Lime, see you, man. Yeah, right on. Yeah. Yeah, I'm probably going to get going soon too myself. But let's see if that worked. I don't want to run the stream. I want to go to the profile. Yeah, look at the pictures. Look at the pretty pictures. No, oh, there's pictures. Here we go. Yeah, cool. Okay, so the image is fine, even though it's gigantic. Cool. So I can go post. I can post some updated images on Twitch. Oh, I thought you were making it funny. Yeah. See you, Lime. Next image. So yeah, anybody joining the stream recently, you're like, what is this? This is a game called Songbringer. I'm working on marketing today. This is, yep, I'm still working on, you know, I'm releasing an alpha version of this game. So lots of marketing work to do. This is kind of annoying having to do this. Big images, but this is the 1080p version. It's got to be on here. Got to go high quality. High quality. That's a good thing for screenshots, right? Yeah, it's looking all right, right? With the boss? Yeah, that's a good image, right? Yeah, I'm really happy. Okay, so the way I got all these good screenshots this time, is I did, okay, so for every single scene that I thought was cool in the game, I'm like, okay, these are some cool scenes, right? I did, let me go to that folder. I can kind of show you guys what I did. Because this really helped. This is the easiest trailer I've done so far because I saved a save file for every single one of the points. So I'm like, okay, I want to do a scene with the waterfall or whatever. And so I would get the whole save game ready for that. And so this save game, if I put it into my game right now, it would put me right back at that waterfall or whatever this is. So then if I want to go re-record later, I've got it. So I did that with several of these, right? Like three outro, I did a three outro B. And so for each one of those scenes, I used ScreenFlick to record high quality retina, 60 frames a second. And so got some really high quality movie files out of that. And then I also did an animated GIF version too. So I would, I got all these screenshots. So now that I've got that, I can go, okay, that shot or whatever is the best one right there. And I can say, all right, I'm gonna turn that into a screenshot. And so that's a really easy way to get a lot of great quality screenshots and a great movie made at the same time, and be able to go back and edit any one of those scenes if I really want to re-record a scene or get a new GIF or get some new screenshots. That turned out to be a freaking excellent way to do it. Submit that one. Let's do this one. Replace it with something new. This is kind of a cool shot too, right here, where he's traversing across this whole room where all the tiles are falling away. I like that one. Man, there's got to be an easier way than this. Having this giant window. I wish there was just a fill all button right here. What's up? Thanks for following. Yeah, oh yeah, great for debugging. Good point. Great for debugging, because yeah, it totally is. When I go back and want to actually debug those scenes, boom! Already got the save file ready to go. I just gotta drop that in, bam. I'm in the game right at that point, very quickly. So yeah, great for debugging, great for rapid development in general, to have these just save files of interesting points of the game that I can go back to. What's this one? This one's cool too. It's sort of shot where lots of lightning going off and stuff. Lots of mayhem. Man, I think next time I'm gonna do this, I'll just make a smaller version of all these ping files, so make it easier for uploading Twitch. This is kind of annoying. Oh, cool, nice. You can freeze your game loop. Cool, good idea. Great idea. Yeah, oh man, excellent idea for sure. In fact, that is probably better than my solution of doing GIFs, right? Or I make I have a thing which saves a screenshot every single frame, or as fast as it can, you know? So, but that's better because you can actually stop and pause and see it happen right there live in the game. Okay, we'll submit that one. This one's a great shot. I love this whole mayhem too. Dude, one of my favorite moments in this game so far is playing that scene right there. It was so rad to fight 99 of those guys with the fire sword. Epic. That's definitely gonna be one of the bosses, or mini bosses or something. Yeah, that's kind of how it works right now. But a good point, right? I think several other people have written in about this too, where those because those are random encounters, those mini bosses. Yeah, there should at least be. Yeah, I guess it's not really that intentional, but it's just kind of how the game was designed. So I do need to do that where, if you respawn. Yeah, the die and respawn screen should never have a mini boss. So you should at least go one more screen over. Somehow I need to do that, you know. I might think of other ways to do that, but yeah, it is kind of confusing, right? If you die during a mini boss. But at least it wasn't a bug. At first that bug was worse. Like that was if you died during a mini boss, you would never ever get to fight them again. So at least allows you to fight them again now. But yeah, I agree. It shouldn't you should never put the mini boss encounter right back on the same screen that you're spawned from. That's just kind of wrong. All right, so it's marketing day. Just marketing, marketing, marketing. Simple stuff. Really, it's almost mindless how simple it is. That's kind of how I prefer it to be, just simple. Is a cool shot. Turned out nice. Yeah, totally. Yeah. It's disorienting, a little confusing whenever you die, right? You're like, "Oh, whoa, what? I had to go back a few screens or whatever." And then yeah, boom. How does the player 2 look? For now, the player 2 is going to be the robot guy. So, I don't think I've played the game on this stream yet at all. But the robot guy, the robot little robot, his name is Jib, and he's cool. And oh, look, I'm right here. Yes. So Jib, the robot, scans the enemy's bodies and stuff. And as player two, you'll be able to go scan bodies and like do other stuff to kind of support and assist. So player two is always going to kind of be a support character. But then also there's also a girl in the game, so she's also going to be the player two. I'm not sure how that's all going to work. I'm not sure if the girl character is gonna have her own abilities or whether she'll also have a sword and kind of have all the same abilities that the main hero does. So I'm still kind of working that out. But for now, the very first bit of gameplay you'll get as player two will be as Jib, the little robot guy over there. He's got his work cut out for him too, right here. Look at this. He's like, ring, 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 scanning all these bodies for items and loot and stuff. There's 99 of these enemies he had to. Wow, I didn't even lose all my health that time. Yep, I'll take that. Don't mind if I do. Thank you. Thank you. Got some more money. Bam. Spend that on something cool. What's this build have? It already has the fire sword. Right, yeah, let's keep up holding these screenshots. Got some more. Oh, but how does the girl look in general? Let me show you the act that the girl actually looks like. All right, Jonah. Good night, man. Later, later. Ugh. Still kind of sleepy. Where is she? Heroes. Bell. Yeah, totally. Totally. Post the Pierre video for sure, man. Here's what the girl looks like. It's sort of like a. I was imagining her having this sort of like telekinesis palm bolt attack. But now I'm kind of considering whether maybe she should have a sword too. And you could, as player one, you could be either her or the guy. And player two is pretty much always Jib. Or maybe best player, I don't know. I really don't know. I know, right? This always happens. Yeah, right? Yeah. She's hot. Yeah. I agree. But I promise, as soon as I get done with this list of screenshots, it's the end of the stream for today. Be back tomorrow. Oops. Oh, wait. Oh, did that just work? I just clicked on it? No, wait. It didn't. I think it did. All I did was click on it. That it? Did that work? No, that doesn't look like it worked. Yeah, that broke. All right. We'll do this the hard way. I'm learning marketing the hard way. Not really, I have. I learned marketing the hard way by failing really hard at it with my last game. But you know what? Sometimes you just have need that kind of lesson in life. You got to do things the hard, wrong way, and then all of a sudden you're like, you know what? There's an easier, better way. All right, our core. Good night, man. Thanks, buddy. What up, Proton? Welcome to the stream. Right. Oh, next shot. Here's one. This one's all right. I don't know. Should I even put that one up? That's, I don't know if it's necessary. Let's put this one up. Lots of new art. Man, it feels really good to have this new alpha gameplay trailer done and all this new art to share because it's been a while making all this new art and now it's great to be sharing it, you know? Making it public and just getting it out there and saying, you know, hey, Songbringer used to kind of look like this and now look at it. I'm starting to get proud of the art, man. I never even thought I'd be an artist. Is it almost a 3 hour stream? Have I really been standing here talking with y'all for 3 hours? Oh my God, wow. It's a long stream. And all I've been doing is like marketing. See how long marketing can take? Especially when you're in kind of a brain dead state of mind like I am today. There's only a couple more. We did that one, that one. Yeah, this is cool. It's kind of this kind of shows that there's item crafting. That's really the purpose of this screenshot here. Craft your items. I mean, it doesn't really say, hey, this is crafting, but you know, hopefully it gives a hint. What up, Zoc Games? Oh yeah, I'm not going yet. I'm waiting. Yeah. Marketing and art, yeah. Art is, you know what's so great about making art is like that's such a great thing to do also while you're in a brainless state or whatever. Like, I find I can always do art, but code requires like full brain power, you know? It's definitely, it uses a lot of juice, uses a lot of calories. Actually, you burn a lot of calories when you're coding. Your brain is a big organ. Needs like bananas and stuff. You hear that, kids? Bananas, just eat them. Act like a monkey. Yeah, doing good, man, doing good. Just finishing up this 3-hour stream of marketing. Celebrating the fact that the alpha is out. Alpha gameplay trailer is out. Have you seen it, Zoc Games? This is the new trailer. Love to get your feedback and thoughts and stuff. Or maybe just reaction. Only a couple more. This one's cool because it shows off the bombs, you know? I thought I did a better screenshot than that one. Well. Done. Almost. Yeah, potassium. Importante. Cool, right on. Yeah, I'd love to get your thoughts, man. It's cool. This whole waterfall. I love this waterfall. I love these ripples. This is a cool scene. New Pierre, how long have I been working on the video? All week. Yeah, it's been a week-long process of making this new video. Screenshots, updating the screenshots everywhere and stuff. I'm still updating. So it's all, I got to keep that in mind. Every time I do a release, it's a good 2 weeks to 3 weeks of debugging and testing, and then another week at least of marketing. New Pierre! Everybody, this is a game that Blood's working on. Pierre, look how distinct his character is. This guy's so, like, lovable. Yeah, Pierre. Oh, man, look at the fire, too. Oh, yeah. Got some garlic. Oh, I see you got a new background too, man. Uh-huh. Ooh, that's the icy cold one. What do you do? How do you get there? Oh, nice move, Pierre. Bow. Yeah, you love coding, right? Nice, cool. I like, thanks, man. That's a cool compliment. Secret of Mana? Yeah. Definitely inspired by Secret of Mana. Definitely. Legend of Zelda, Secret of Mana, Crystalis, even Final Fantasy a little bit. Well, how long have you been working on the game? Oh, since November, so yeah, about 9 months, 9 or 10. Happy Wheels. Happy Wheels. Oh man. Which makes me think of Happy Meals. That's like a childhood memory of mine, eating Happy Meals at McDonald's. Let's get this screenshot here of this 308 million worlds thing, which really, helps people get a grasp that this is a procedurally generated game. So, that's kind of important too. With screenshots, it's important to kind of tell a little bit of story, right? Or get a story of the game, right? What kind of game is this? What game am I going to be playing here? So you really want to get people the context to be able to understand what the basic story of your game is. Not really the story, but the message. I don't know. How do you say that? Let's do these. These are two great funny screenshots here.
House this Halloween, so we're giving out milk.
And last image of the day, ending up a 3-hour stream, man. Time flies when you're having fun. That's probably the most important lesson I can share on game development is just to have fun with what you do. Every bit of it. If you're not having but fun with code or marketing or sprites or whatever, music, whatever's stopping you, find out why it's stopping you and then find out a way that you could somehow get the same thing done but without it stopping you, you know? Make it fun. Basically, make anything that you do in game development, make it fun. Nice. Right on. Cool. I'm glad. The music there is meant to be sort of that background style, which is just supposed to be kind of mesmerizing and stuff. Right. And the game isn't really even over yet. It doesn't really do anything for you at the end yet, but there'll be lots of story, lots of cool stuff happening at the end of the game, middle of the game, whatever. Yeah. All right, so that's it for today's stream, you guys. I've just done a lot of marketing, like posted on Facebook, posted on TigSource, posted on Tumblr, updated the screenshots here on the Twitch page. And there's a lot left to do. There's more. I got to update all the text. A lot of text to be updated. And little images to be inserted in the text and stuff like that. So lots of work left to do to market just this alpha release. But all of it is turning out really well. I'm really proud of it. So thank you once again, everybody. Yeah, see ya. Thank you so much for all your help, all your support, all your ideas, all your feedback, comments, bug reports, everything. Thank you guys. This game would not be what it is without y'all. I can say that with 100% confidence. So we'll check y'all later.